Cheers, Merry Christmas. Don't forget that Jesus is the reason for the season.
Okay. Can this be a molly whopping joy? Stop it, status shocking. Don't do nothing foolish, poopy. Understand it, God watching.
Merry Christ was and is to come. Hallelujah. It is December 25th. Y'all know the reason for the season? Or no? Hi, guys. It's your girl, Cyn, also known as Cynthia, C-Y-N. Okay? I thought, like, I was going to do, like, a vlog. Spend the day with me. Don't spend Christmas alone type of situation. But it's, like, 4 in the afternoon. I haven't done much. But we're here. And I was also thinking about giving y'all a December haul. This is, I literally kept all the stuff that I've received for, like, my birthday and Christmas to give you guys a haul. I know that's videos that people like to see during the holidays, but I'm on my bed right now and I haven't, like I said, I haven't done much. Three people I got gifts for called me and opened their gifts with me. That was enjoyable. It's cold. I got my robe on. I also got my Christmas stuff from last year. It says resting Grinch face, but we're happy this year. We're happier this year than last year. So I just put it on because it was festive. I think I'm about to eat, about to clean a little bit, tidy my room, and then I'm gonna open some packages and build a bouquet. I'm gonna show y'all the bouquet because that's one of the things like I got for myself for Christmas. Hold on. I'm so cold, I literally don't wanna move. But I got this bouquet. It's a Lego bouquet. And I just, you know, I don't have a green thumb. At the moment, I do not have a green thumb. So I'm just like, you know what? I want flowers for my bathroom to stay there because the window seal is just perfect. Here are my flowers. And I even got a vase, but that's farther, so I'm not going to be able to do that. But we're going to set it up. I'm going to open some Christmas gifts. Pasta Blanca. I may go out today because it is Christmas and it is also my friend's mom's birthday. So, yeah. They're celebrating and I was invited to just come over, play some games, have some fun. So, I don't see why not. If it was any other year, I probably would have said no. But, y'all, the couple years that have passed, like, Christmas has been depressing, not gonna lie. And I think it's just, you know, we are in control of that. Like, I feel like some things we feel like are not in our control. But if we really think about it, we can control things and how they affect us and how we do them. So, like, last couple Christmases, I kind of, like, spent them in my room in a dark mood and just sad and just wanting Christmas to go a different way. Wanting Christmas to be with my family. Y'all know the ideal Christmas. It's just like it didn't happen for me. But this year I actively was like, nah, I'm not gonna be like seasonal depression. I'm not gonna say that that's not a thing, but like that was a thing that I've experienced in the past or like I've let rule over me. And this year I was like, absolutely not. And let me tell y'all, you have dominion and authority. So you need to just walk in it. Cause this season, this holiday season, I've been good. Thanksgiving passed, I was chilling. It is Christmas and I'm smiling. That is a good thing. So yeah, I actively was like, I'm not trying to have a bad Christmas. I'm not trying to have a bad holiday season. I don't want to be seasonally depressed. And it's working and I praise God for that. So I kind of like planned a day for myself. So if you guys are spending Christmas alone and if you know Jesus Christ, just know that he is an omnipresent God and he is with you. So you're not really alone. Just invite him to your space and watch, you know, watch your mood change. That is my, like, quick welcome, hey, reminder, love y'all, etc. There's a lot of things that I want to do, but we're going to see where the Lord guides us.
Hey, as y'all can see, I was jamming to my holy music. The place I was listening to was upbeat gospel music. Literally, that's what it is on Apple Music. But I'm back. I was like fixing my room. I was gonna show y'all, but I'm like, y'all wanna see what I do for real. I wrapped up my hair because your girl has a silk press, and when she starts sweating, it get puffy. So I put it up, and I know that I'm gonna like take a shower if I'm going out. So why not already have it wrapped? Even more flatter, right? Put on my little Christmas hat. I have these are from last year, but like I'm not really grinching face. I'm smiling. My bed is made. And this is my Christmas tree, literally. I want to put y'all on to a, this is my holiday air freshener. This is the Febreze Air Mist Smooth and Restore Whipped Warm Sugar and Shea Butter. Whipped Warm Sugar and Shea Butter. This right here. I haven't sprayed in my room yet, but this is my bathroom scent right now. And she is divine. This is a divine scent right here. Febreze, hear me when I tell y'all, y'all be doing a big one. Let me show y'all just two more I have. Oh wait, these are limited edition. I'm mad that I didn't get another one of this because I went to the store and I didn't see it. But this is Fig and Plum, and this one is Cranberry Tart. This one is a classic. If you've been rocking with me for a long time, you know her. She's faithful, she true. Nobody like her could do. But yeah, those three are my, like, this is what I be using to make my room smell good. So now that my room is clean, I'm gonna pour me a little sparkling drink and we're gonna open some gifts. And y'all, your girl is like, when I say drink, I don't, the people who like alcohol, don't get excited, because my drink is, if your soul's not anchored in Jesus, you will surely drift away. Okay, so we are going to be drinking the Sugar Plum Sparkling Beverage. This is plum and white grape juice beverage from Concentrate. Shout out to Trader Joe's. I've never had this before, but I was like, let me have a little sparkling drink for me and my plans on Christmas. So here we are. And I got my cup. So let's pop the bottle. I'm sweating. This way. Okay. Hopefully this doesn't make a mess because I just cleaned. Oh, it's a twist off. We love a good. Okay. A little weak. Okay. She bubbling. When it bubbles, I refuse to open. Okay. They do it like this, right? Gotta tilt it. Cheers, Merry Christmas. Don't forget that Jesus is the reason for the season. Okay. Let's try her. Different. I don't hate it. Let's open gifts, shall we? Okay, as you guys can see, obviously we're on my bed and I'm gonna open Christmas gifts. This one's got my name on it. I've got these Christmas gifts, but I like waited till Christmas open. Is that anybody like get, you don't open it until Christmas? That's me. And especially because I know that like, I may not get gifts, I like to save my gifts until the actual day of. So I'm gonna take them in the order that I received them, which was this first. And this I got from my aunt, and she gave me the, this is not really a part of it, but I'm gonna include it because she gave it to me. This is the Our Daily Bread, December, January, February, 2023, 2024. So I think I'm gonna keep this in my car. I have a devotional in my room. Even though it's about to end, me and my friend are gonna switch devotional books. Oh, and I got another devotional book. Okay, we're getting cut straight. But I'm gonna keep this in my car to start me off the year right. Even though we serve an omnipresent God, or I serve an omnipresent God. It's reminders, right? Our daily bread. Then I got this brace. Oh, and she's purple. I love this. Oh my gosh. Okay, so let me get closer. Do y'all feel far? I feel like I'm far. Okay, so I got this card, right? And it says, "You are beautiful, chosen, made for a purpose, a precious child of God, loved forever." And it has Bible verses for each of them. And then it came with this bracelet that is so beautiful. And y'all know how I get about purple. Okay, hold on. Let's take it out the packaging because I'm about to put this on right now. Thank you. And it has a cross on it. Oh, I love it. I love her. I just feel like this is like the Lord is showing me that my left arm is powerful. Although people used to get beaten for being left-handed, your girl is a powerful lefty, okay? Because this bracelet too, the silver one, is a gift for my birthday. Shout out to Neef. She got me this and it has my baptism date on it and it says I love you. So it's like my heavenly hand. Y'all usually do y'all right hand, but my heavenly hand is my left. Okay. And it came with this cute bag that like I guess for storage. So we're definitely gonna be keeping her and I want to keep this in my Bible because I want to go over these. Over here we talk about Jesus. And I feel like the Lord is showing me like what I'm already asking for so early. And I'm just so grateful because I was like 2024, I want to work on seeing myself the way the Lord sees me. And my planner literally, it says, "I am fearfully and wonderfully made." Now I'm getting, "You are beautiful, chosen, made for a purpose, a precious child of God, loved forever." So we're gonna, Okay. Thank you. All right, next. We got this package from my good sis, Chantel. And it says, "Two cinnamon." That's me. Look at, can we talk about the packaging for a second? Like, they know how to wrap gifts. One thing about me, I'm a gift bagger. Oh, wow. I was talking about packages being wrapped and then them being in Amazon boxes today. Not gonna say what I said, but. Oh. So I got this sweater and it's crazy because I actually have a similar sweater. So, wait, there's a back. Okay, hold on, what size is this? Looks a little big. A large. This is large. Okay, this is, yeah, you might have to shrink up. But it says, "Jesus loves you." And guys, I learned that in sign language. Jesus loves you. And then it says, "Check the front for good news." I love her. Do you love it or no? Love it or no? I feel like it's a little big, but it's because my friends know I'm lengthy, so they're like, they don't wanna, sometimes mediums don't be mediums on me. But this is good. This is just good. Even if I shrink her, she'll be like perfect. Perfect sizing. Thank you. I love it. Okay. Next up we have from my good sis. Hey. She inspired me to wrap somebody else's gift like this. I was like, oh yeah, you don't want me to get into it at all. You think I can get it out? Well, okay, boom. Yep. All right, so we got, oh. So this is the Cabela Workshop. Ooh, 100% vegan. Oh, we got some vegan masks. We got some vegan mask. Might do one tonight. So there's pineapple peel off. We have aloe vera cream mask, tea tree mud mask, pomegranate peel off, watermelon peel off, lavender mud mask. All vegan, dermatology approved, suitable for all skin types. Okay. Thank you. I love. And this right here, this packaging, okay. Can y'all, like, this is holiday for real. This is beautiful packaging. Like, I don't even wanna, you know when you think you could say packaging? Even though you're never gonna use it. But this is beautiful. Ah! See? I already ripped it. I already ripped it. Oh, no. What happened to it? Okay, so it's like so many things I'm experiencing, but I just got a new devotional book, but I'm looking at it because it's been, she's a little hurt. She's a little hurt over here. She's a little hurt. She's a little hurt up here. I don't know what happened, but we got a KJV devotional book. We're going to read page 25 because today is the 25th. Blind faith, for we walk by faith, not by sight. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 7. Have a sweet sister in the Lord who has been blind since birth. Throughout her life journey, she has been demonstrating her faith in God and others. She waits with great anticipation for her sight to be restored, knowing the first face she will see will be the face of Jesus. I've had the privilege of being her eyes, guiding her through stores, restaurants, and church, while she simply holds onto my arm and listens to my voice. Every time she buckles her seat belt in the car, she has faith I will drive her safely to her destination. Even though she lacks sight, my friend never gives up. Her faith in God is strengthened daily. As a believer, I desire an enduring faith where I am fully trusting and relying on God, His word, and His promises. My friend is a beautiful picture of trusting God when I cannot see how He is working or understanding His movements. Like my friend, I look forward to the day I will see my Savior face to face and see how He has tenderly leading me all along. Thank you. Love me a good devotional. I don't know about y'all, but devotional books. Now I have two new devotional books. And this is KJV. I don't know about y'all if y'all read your Bible in KJV, but I'm a KJV reader. King James Version. Okay, last but not least, we have this one. This one comes from my good sis Leanne. La 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 la. In the same household as Chantel. As you can see, the packaging is consistent. I don't know what I'm trying to do. Oh, I'm trying to find an open one. Oh, I thought, see, if I, it would have been cool if I just ripped it all the way like that. Boom. What is she? Ooh, Bible study. Creating me a heart of peace. What is she? Oh, it's just a Bible study. Okay, wait. Is this a, hold on. Is this like a whole? Okay, so this is a 6-week Bible study, I think. All right. I got a Bible study book, y'all. Create in me a heart of peace. Ooh. Praise the Lord in advance for this peaceful year that I'm going to have for 2024 because Lord knows I need it. Okay. I'm excited. I'm very grateful and I'm thankful for all of my gifts. I love them and I definitely have to send my thanks to my people. So y'all, I feel like you can just see by the visual, by the way I'm opening my gifts, by the gifts that I've received, that my life has just been a 360. And I just want to come on here and say, like, you know, I probably said this earlier, but just like the gifts that we have received that are tangible, like the gifts that we were given that we cannot see, are so profound, so much greater. And I don't lose sight of that, expecting the gift, love. Once y'all understand the reason for the season and that it's not about the gifts, life is good. I don't know about y'all, but I love to have my Jesus stuff out. Like, yeah, let me read you. Let's study. Right. So that was me opening my gifts. I think I'm about to get started with this bouquet. And then this is the vase I got for it. I got this at like Dollar Tree. Figured it'd be a good vase. And I'll like put stuff in it if I need to weigh it down. But let's go do this. Ah, my gifts. I'm gonna send my thank yous and then I'll come back. I haven't done Lego since I was a child. What is this, my lord? I just sorted the first. This is the first pack. This pile right here, you can see. And I'm missing two pieces. Literally, two pieces are like the first two steps. I'm missing this piece right here. Lego, where art thou? And I'm missing one of my branches. So that's unfortunate, and I really don't want to open the other packs because I'm sure that it would have been in this pack one to build this. So I don't know, maybe it's like I'm sitting on it rolled. But the way I opened everything, I was intentional. I sorted everything so I wouldn't lose anything. And your girl is missing two pieces. So we're still gonna carry on. We move because we trust in the Lord. And if I find the pieces later, then, you know, yay. If not, we still gonna move and figure it out afterwards. But I just had to come on and do my update because I feel like the timeline is going, but nothing's really happening. And at the same time, things are still happening. But yeah, missing two pieces. And I sorted everything because I'm like, maybe it's because it's not sorted. But no, it's really sorted, and I don't see her. Where art thou, peace? So good, you don't even want to pause it, man. But copyright is not a thing. I wanted to come back in and show y'all my flowers. So we have this one, two different versions, one curves, one is regular, right? We got this one's first flower that gave me no trouble after dealing with confusing pieces, right? We're starting to get bouquet. Got these two, it's my flowers. And then I have this one. Hold on. It's like, I can't just drop them on the floor. I have this one, but I'm missing some pieces at the moment. But they're supposed to be like yellow pieces. I'm about to show you. Oh, enemy. Well, actually, I don't even. Oh, yeah. So this is this flower, but I don't have those yellow pieces. But that is my flowers for now. I feel like I did a good job. This is what I have left. I sorted everything by like pieces so that when I come back, I can work on it. I'm actually about to go get ready to go head to my friend's house so we can celebrate her mom's birthday. It started at 7. It's currently like 7 something, but like I live 20 minutes away. So I'm honestly just gonna like get in the shower, get ready to go. Not gonna try to do nothing crazy because I know we're about to be in the house playing games, just having a good time. And I don't wanna like drag it. So yeah. I'm about to get ready. This is my bag wall. Every season, I kind of change my bag wall to make it festive. So this is this season. I had my Santa hat up, but I took it down. But got my stocking. And then I just did like white, gold, silver vibes. Like I have my earmuffs, my hats, silver bag, etc. But yeah. So this is my clothing rack. Not really, but it is. So this is the outfit that I'm planning to wear. This top I got from Burlington. If you guys missed this haul, I'll put it here. But it's this Tommy Hilfiger. I don't know why I can't say that. Tommy Hilfiger top. I'm gonna wear it open, right? Denim and quality with this just like regular white top open. Hopefully I don't get too hot because my armpits are not shaved. So, but like that's why exactly why I'm wearing that and not like a long sleeve. And then I'm gonna put on these. I'm gonna put on these jeans that I got, that I thrifted, a little tight. Your girl's got her holiday weight on her. But they're so fire, so bomb. That's the outfit. I'ma wear white sneakers, but it doesn't matter because I'm gonna take off my shoes when I get there. And I'm bringing house slippers because I learned my lesson too many places I'm going without my house slippers. When it's like your socks, you just bring house slippers. If you're going to your friend's house, bring house slippers. If you have house slippers, bring them. I'm gonna bring like house socks. Let me show y'all. So like I have these holiday house socks. Probably I'm gonna put on my feet because they have like the grippy bottoms. So I'll be back.
So we got Bobby with the blood red hands on a ride. And we got, I forgot. What does it mean? What's your name?
Dasher.
Oh, my bad. We got Dasher with the dashing cups on the left. Let's go. Timer starts in 3, 2, 1, go.
It's hard because you think you pick it up.
Right, but then you're going, yeah, okay.
In the beginning, I really thought I was picking them up.
Make sure you're only using the cups.
More than one at a time.
Let's go. Yeah, whatever your technique is. Let's go. We have 10 more seconds on the clock. 10 seconds on the clock. Misha, I'm close to you. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Three person, every reindeer for themselves. We got Blitzen on a right lap. We got Bobby on the right. We got Dare on the left. And we got Champ on the left. We're competing to find the strongest reindeer of all time in 3, 2, 1, go. Let's go. They coming in strong. Nobody came to play. Not one person is playing with anybody else. We got 20 more seconds on the clock. 20 seconds on the clock. Oh, they're flying. Oh. 10, 9. I think they're all gone. For the final battle of the night, we got Bobby with the blood red hands on the right. And on the left, we got Champ. Both undefeated. Let's go. In 3, 2, 1, go.
Yeah.
We got 30 seconds on the clock. 30 seconds on the clock. 30 seconds on the clock. Let's see.
What's going on?
It's real strong over on Bobby's side.
We need to get a playback.
We most certainly can do a playback. Yep, throw it back up.
Dustin in the play.
We got 10 seconds on the clock. 10 seconds on the clock.
Sorry.
All right, let's see.
Hey, peoples. I just got home. After I got ready, I kind of just left. But yeah, this is my outfit. I had on the jacket that I showed you guys, but I ended up giving it to my friend's sister because she wanted it. And I was like, you know what? I don't wear this jacket. Like, it's been in my closet for ages, and today's my first time wearing it. You can have it. So, I am bare. This is the look. The top is from Cider. Pants are thrifted. And they go, I love these pants so much. And they're tight. I think I'm going to have to cut them, put a band, because I can't let them go. Because I just got them. But, like, they are tall girl friendly. Y'all see they go past my ankle? Like, look at that. I'm stepping on them without shoes. Bag is from Target. I didn't even show y'all my nails. I did these nails for my birthday. Nails by moi, of course. Y'all know, bracelet by my aunt. Pandora. Abbott Leon. I feel like I'm saying it wrong. And then earrings are from Cider. And hair is stale. But this is the fit. Cute little holiday birthday situation. I'm going to do a quick haul of what I got. So, got a plate of food. Y'all know a good plate. We got sorrow. We love a good sock. This the meal right here. What else did I get? a phone, this thing, because we were playing games and there was prizes. So this is one of my prizes. This is my bag. I went over there with a bag. Pro tip, when you're going somewhere, go with a bag. Have my, this is my quick stuff. So I have my lip gloss, my lip balm. I got gum, what else? And then my perfume in here. But this is like my wallet, my keys, tissue, AirPods, okay? Right? I also got, I won silly sticks. But clearly it's open. I didn't have any yet, but we were just all taking some. I also won a eye mask with caffeine. So for my sleepless nights. I got some Tootsie Roll lollipops. And I didn't win this, but I saw this and I was like, can I have this? And they said yes. So came home with a lollipop. Oh my gosh. And my friend's mom, the birthday lady, gave me this perfume from Bath & Body Works called Luminous. And it smells like it gives like grown woman. That's what I get. Because I don't know why I had to do that. But this gives grown woman right here. Bath & Body Works, you did what you had to do with this one. That's definitely going to be mine. You know when you don't want to use your expensive perfume, but you want to still smell good? Like, you know, you're not going anywhere, but you still want to give. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah. So, that is my haul from my friend's house. I'm about to get out of these clothes, put on back my robe. Well, I didn't have my robe on earlier. Put on back my PJs because I'm still in good spirits. And kind of going to, like, jam out to my music. If any of my friends call me, I'll do that. But, yeah. Today was a good day. And I'm very grateful. Very grateful. Very thankful. To the Lord, I thank you for the day that you've given me, because y'all don't know, like, this time, this season used to be really dark for me, and allowing myself to walk in my authority, walk with my dominion that I was given from my Lord, is just like, I can be in control of these situations. Like, I can do better. And even if I'm not in control, I know that to an extent I can control how I feel, right? What I said earlier was like years prior to, it would just be like seasonal depression vibes. And it was dark for me. It was so much so that I went to my friend's house today, and I've been invited to her house every year since I met her. And that was since 2019. It is 2023, and this is the first time I'm going for Christmas. But it was like for her mom's birthday, but just like because I wasn't in the right headspace, and I was just very... Just not okay. I was just like, I don't want to go anywhere and let my mood take other people's moods down. But like, today's been a good day and I had fun and I'm thankful for the Lord. I'm thankful for all the gifts that I did get. And I hope you guys enjoyed the gifts that you guys got. Don't forget the reason for the season. And if you guys aren't following Creatively Cyn, it's a problem with the Bob. If you guys aren't following Creatively Cyn, make sure you go check out my business page, because I have some holiday content that I put up, and it's like holiday content, but it's also fundamental about Jesus, just all good vibes. So I'm liking this bob, white, silver, blue. Like, this look right now is giving me like businesswoman, and I don't even have my lip gloss. Hold on. Fenty Heat. Supposedly Fenty is number one on like people who use businesses who use forced laborers, and we don't like that. However, all the Fenty that I own, I got from my dad because he works with the company. But when you're feeling low, nowhere to go, just under all of my help. All of my help comes from you. If I didn't say it already, Jesus